Welcome to our show. I'm Shweta Talwar and with me is Mr. Ankur Dhawan, Chief Business Officer, Resale Prop Tiger. Welcome to our show, Mr. Dhawan.
Thank you, Shweta.
So in 2015, private equity investment was up by 72%, which is the highest since 2008. Why do private equity investors choose real estate when prices are still stagnant?
Very good question, Shweta. See, for this, we need to understand what kind of investment we are getting in the Indian real estate market. So there are two forms of investment which are being done by private equity players. One is the debt instrument or structured debt transaction, as we say, and the other is the equity. In last few years, since 2008 and 2010 crisis after that, the investment which has come in India in real estate has come in form of a structured debt transaction. In a structured debt transaction, any investor get a minimum coupon which he can get. So minimum coupon can be ranging from 18 to 20%. So that means that the developer, the investor is not actually dependent on the market or how it performs for recovering his money. He is getting interest payment from the developer, which is defined as 18-20%, and there might be some upside if the market does well. So that was the reason, because of, despite the market being stagnant, investor had no such issues by giving debt. And you look at this 18-20% coupon we're talking about, it's pretty high when compared to any other market in the world. But recently now the second part of the question is that equity transactions have also increased. Now the people who are doing equity transactions are having a positive view of the market. They believe that the market will start picking up in the coming 2-3 years. They have a very, they believe in the India story. They believe in the long-term India growth story, and they believe that this is the segment which will grow. Also, they are focusing mostly in affordable segment, which is very well known fact that in India, there's a huge demand gap in affordable segment. So the investors are willing to invest in that particular segment.
Mr. Dhawan, of the 25,683 crore rupees invested by private equity investors, 18,000 crore rupees was in the residential segment. How will the private equity investors help the home buyers?
So residential segment is one of the major beneficiary of the private equity investment. As you mentioned clearly, 18,000 has gone there. The reason is the developers who have launched project were expecting the market to move up. When the market moves up, then it's easy for them to construct a house and demand further payment from the customers who have bought the home. Because the market was so stretched, developers are not able to sell sufficient units in the beginning itself, and they are right now struggling for the cash flow. So when the cash is not there, you stop doing the construction of the project itself. And this is a vicious cycle. If you stop constructing, you will not be able to demand more money, and if you stop constructing, new customers also will not come. Now in this case, a buyer who has bought a home has no idea when the project will complete. This is when the private equity investor comes in. He gives sufficient cash to a developer for completion of the project, and that helps a home buyer that at least now he knows that once the private equity investment has come, his project will get complete. Also, he'll be able to get a definite timeline, because private equity investment comes for a defined timeline of 2 to 5 years, whatever. And in that case, he knows that my project will get completed in this particular timeline. So both the benefits the home buyer gets, completion as well as the timeline of the completion.
Thank you for being on our show, Mr. Dhawan, and solving all our queries.
Thank you, Shweta.
Stay tuned and keep watching. You can also follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube.